So I just wanted to talk quickly about pose-based deformation in Maya and an idea of a way that you can do that. We can go into the Windows and then down into the Node Editor, which is very similar to what you guys are used to with regards to Node Editing tool sets. I've got the base shape here, and I'm actually going to go ahead and create a polygons cube. I'll actually delete history off that guy. Get rid of one of those extra nodes there. And I will take this guy off to the side. Just make sure I've got those connections in here. I'll just take a quick look through this. So we've got our base male here, and we've got our cube here. We have our base male original and base male shape present here, and then of course our P cube shape. I'm going to go ahead and expand these guys and their options, and I'm going to go out mesh on this guy and in mesh onto the cube, and lo and behold, I have a lovely duplicate and no longer a cube. And of course this is linked up just like that. And what we can do with this is we can actually go ahead and this is an intermediate sort of rigging stage. Make sure that you can set it back to its default pose before you get into this. And I can go in here and make alterations. So I've got this guy here. And of course, that collapse is very ugly. And so I can go ahead and make some adjustments to this as a shape by going in there and using most of the regular tools, pressing the B key to do, you know, soft selection, move that stuff around, change the form of this, holding down B and changing the area of influence for that. And press F to get in there. Change that a little bit, maybe pull that down. And I'm not gonna tweak this entire thing to make it perfect, but you get the general idea. And so there you've got my dog barking. We've got a nice shape here, and I can go ahead and set this guy back. I'm just going to close this guy here. I'll set him back to his zero position. And I get this nifty and deformed mesh here, which I'm going to make sure that this guy is also set to zero. He's got some animation on him. And I'm just going to go ahead and take that and duplicate it. Now, the wonderful thing about the duplicate is that when I go ahead and take this guy and move him, the duplicate doesn't change. So I can take him and give him a name, like left shoulder fix, and use that as a blend shape, and I can blow this guy awake. And once that guy is gone, use him as a nice little blend shape addition. And I've already got one on here, so I just take this one. And rather than going to create deformers blend shape to add a new node, I would edit deformers and add a blend shape. And I'm going to need to specify fix shapes, and then that works. And of course, under view, panels, panel blend shape. I've got that in there. There's my little slider. Let's just do it here. Panels, panel, blend shape. And you can see that. Of course, I can then just do a set driven key. So under animate, do a driven key set. I have my left shoulder fix here as a driven object, and I can go with my shoulder bone here as a driver and take its rotation in Z. Again, I just did a really simple fast rig for this video, so don't judge me. And we're going to go ahead and let's make sure that I have this guy selected actually. And fix shapes and load driven. And under fix shapes, I should have my fix there. So there's my left shoulder fix. And I can set my initial key, go ahead and make my modifications, set my next key, and I'll get animation based on the movement of the joint. So there's the idea. Hopefully that works out for you. That's all I got for now.